Hello everyone, this is Sudipta from Technical Potpourri and welcome to my new video. So here in this video, I'm going to show you how you can build an automation where attachments from your email will be automatically stored into your Google Drive. So without any further delay, let's build the automation in it. So here I am in my N18 workflow. So first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to click on this plus sign on the search node. I'm going to select Gmail. And here I'm going to select on message received. So this is a note, and again here is a Gmail account. I have a dedicated video where I've shown you how you can connect your Google with your N8N. There is a slightly process change recently happened, so I highly recommend that you please go and watch that video so that you can also connect your Google account with N8N. Now I assume that you have already watched that video or you know how to connect Google with N8N. So here I have my Gmail account. This is going to poll every minute, and here it's going to on message received, on every message received. I'm not going to simplify that. And here I am going to select the option. Under this option, I'm going to select here and download attachments and click on download attachment. And here I'm going to click on fetch test event. And looks like this is a big email that came to me recently, but I'm not interested on this event. So here I'm going to attach one invoice. So let's attach this one and send that email. So with that, let's open this one and fetch test event. It looks like I have received my first invoice, and here is attachment. So with that, if Gmail configured, I'm going to click on this plus sign again. And here I'm going to click on Gmail. And then here I'm going to click on get a message. So here again, same thing, everything looks good. On the message ID, I am going to select table. I'm going to select JSON and get this message ID. And with that, download attachments and click on download attachments. Everything looks good. So let's click on test step. And again, everything looks good. Okay, so now with this one, let's click on this plus sign. My intention is like, what were the output, what were the attachments, right? I'm to upload that attachment to my Google Drive inside a folder called invoice test with N8N. Okay, so for that, I'm going to click on this plus sign, and here I'm going to search for Google Drive. And here I'm going to do the operation as upload file. Here everything looks good. In the data file name, data field name, I am going to replace this with the this name, which is attachment 0. And in the file name, I am going to make it a little bit of change. I'm going to make it first. It's coming from .item.json.email.item.binary.attachments.filename. So basically, this is the file name. And I'm going to attach the email subject along with that so that I know this attachment came along with this email. And finally, I'm going to store that inside my invoice test under this folder. So looks good. If I click on test step now, looks like it's okay. If I go here and refresh, yep, there is a new file with the test invoice this came. So let's delete that. Let's go back here and save that and mark this as active. And wait, let's go to the execution. And now let's send another email. And this time I am going to attach invoice 2 and send that email. Now let's come here, let's wait for the workflow to be triggered. Okay, looks like my workflow has triggered, so let's click on that. And yes, the workflow has executed. So let's go back to my folder, and I can see there's single attachment email, so that's the subject and followed by this one. So looks good. So let's do one more round of testing. Let's send another email. Test multiple attachments email, send it to me, and this time I'm going to attach all three. and let's send that email. Let's go back and wait for another execution to happen. Okay, seems like another execution has started. And looks like everything is done. So let's go back here and refresh. No, this is not correct. I have attached three attachments, but it only uploaded the only single one. So what's wrong? The wrong is that this workflow is not built in a way that it can handle multiple attachments. Can we make that happen? Yes, definitely. So let's build that. First, I'm going to deactivate this flow and go to my editor. And here, I'm going to delete this one. Okay. Now let's click on plus sign. And here, I'm going to click on an element called edit fields. And inside edit fields, I'm going to click on manual mapping. And here, I click on add fields. Here, first, I'm going to give a name as attachments. And this one, I'm going to give expression. And here I am going to gmail.item.binary.is. Now as you can see, it creates an array with three of my attachments. And another one I want to do, which is basically my message ID. Message underscore ID, and message ID comes from an expression, which is basically, if I go here, this is my ID. So let's click on here. So now let's click on test step and let's go to the table. So these are the all the attachments and this is the message ID. So far so good. Click on save. With this one, what I need to do is that I need to bring one more element, which is split out. So here what I am doing is that which field I want to do the split out. Definitely I have to do the split out of this field. So let's click on here and under include I'm going to choose all other fields and let's click on test step. So I think there is something wrong. The wrong thing which I done is that here this should not be a string, it should be an array. So now click on test step. Okay, now it looks good because now it's an array and here is a message ID. With that, if I come here and try to split out, okay. So each message ID attachment, same message ID three times, but linked to three different attachments. So far, so good. With that, what I am going to do, I'm going to click on this plus sign and bring the element called merge. So what merge is going to do, it's going to merge the data from multiple streams once the data from the multiple streams are available. So here I'm going to click on merge. And in the merge, the mode is I'm going to do the combine. And here I'm going to do the combine based on the matching fields where the fields to have a different name. So I'm enabling that. And here I am going to choose the first, I'm going to choose the message ID. And in the second one, I am going to choose the ID field, which is here. And then here, merge needs two data. One is coming from the split and the second I want to give it from the Gmail. With that, if I open and test step, I am getting for this message ID, this is attachment. Similarly, for this message ID, this is attachment one. And for this message ID, this is attachment number two. So I have three attachments here now. So far, so good. With that, what I am going to do, I'm going to bring the Google Drive. Google Drive is going to do the upload file. Same thing, everything looks good. Here on the data, I'm going to delete that in the expression. I am going to bring JSON.attachments. So basically all the attachments it will come. And here in the file name, again the same thing. I'm going to bring the expression. And here I'm going to first bring the JSON.subject and then And this time I'm going to ping the merge dot item dot JSON dot attachments. And I am going to store inside this invoice test folder. And let's click on test step. It's doing the execution. Hopefully it will run. Let's go back here. And as you can see, I have this 3-1 test multiple attachments, invoice, attachment 0, attachment 1, attachment 2. So far so good. So what I can do, I can delete all of them and come here and save this and make it active. With that, let's open the execution and let's send another email. The email goes to me, doing multiple email attachment testing, and here I am attaching all three of them and then send the email. With that, let's come back to the flow and wait. Okay, seems like the execution has happened. So let's click on that and the execution has happened. So let's go back to my Google Drive and refresh. And as you can see, I have all three attachments being uploaded in my Google Drive. So as you can see, this is a very easy way how you can automate your attachments and automatically save that to your Google Drive. And I hope you can take advantage of this automation to implement multiple business requirements based on your need. So if you like this video, please hit the like icon, please subscribe to my channel, and please hit the bell icon so that in future when I'll publish new videos like this, you'll be the first person to be notified. Till then, thank you. Bye-bye.